Hey guys, this is Vipa Stambhat and welcome back to my YouTube channel once again. So first of all, I just wanted to tell you that I am really sorry for just vanishing off of the face of YouTube and not being able to post for almost 4 months. So I really apologize for that, but I did have a valid reason, and actually all of you really deserve to know that reason, because you all kept asking me all this time like why I am not active on YouTube, what am I doing, why am I not making videos, what is happening. So back in March, I was just casually watching Netflix on my laptop one night and suddenly it shut down completely. I tried for several hours to get it back and I tried literally everything on the internet except take it open, but it did not even start. It was like completely brain dead. That is the reason I could not continue with YouTube. Since you know that the lockdown started back in March in India and everything was completely closed at that time, at least for 1 or 2 months. So there was no way that I could go and get my laptop fixed or do anything about it. So it was best for me to kind of take a break. So anyway, this lockdown has been like really hard on all of us, but I got my braces removed, obviously, and I had promised you all that I would definitely make a video about my experience with braces and what I had to go through and what all I know about braces. I am making this video only for you, so let's go, I guess. I literally had like so many plans for this video. I wanted to vlog the whole thing, also introduce my orthodontist to you guys, because actually he knows that I post on YouTube and stuff, so he actually would have loved to be in my video. Sadly, that all could not happen. Everything happened in such emergency. He was all dressed up in this
hazmat
suit and so was his assistant, so I just kind of went there. He removed the brackets in like 5 minutes, he cleaned it up in like 2 minutes, and then that was it. I couldn't really do anything. When I look back at my pictures now, before I had braces, I think to myself that I didn't even need them that much, but I kind of made a big deal out of, you know, getting braces for years and years. Like, there's no significant difference, you know. It was not like my teeth were totally out of shape or something like that. There was just one crooked tooth on my right side of my face here, this one, and a few misaligned bottom teeth. But since I was a child, I really hated that one crooked tooth of mine, because it felt like whenever I smiled or I was speaking, it was always like hanging out there out of my mouth, and it felt like it was stabbing my lip. It was always kind of touching it and it was really uncomfortable, and I really wanted to like get rid of it so much. I always told my parents that please let me get braces, please let me get braces, but they never did. I don't know if it was about money or was it about the myths that my mom carried about braces. She had this cousin who had braces. After her braces were removed, her teeth apparently went inside her mouth like a lot, too much, more than they wanted, and her lips started hanging out. That's what my mom told me. I don't know, I've never seen her. So my mom always saw that braces actually deform your shape and whatever God has given is the best, which is true, but But anyway, whenever I told my parents that I wanted to get braces, they were like, no, you look good like this. Aise hi acche lagte ho, itni cute lagti hai, ye wo. My mom also used to compare me to that actress Mousini Chatterjee all the time. Like, look at her, she has that tooth and you look like her and all of that. To, you know, make me feel better about myself, which is nice, but they actually wasted a lot of my time. But having a few misaligned teeth here and there is not the only reason that you get braces. If you go to a dentist, he will tell you that like getting braces is more than just about looks. So there is one more reason why I got braces. Whenever I went to a dentist for regular checkup or cleaning or whatever problems, they always used to suggest that I should get braces because I always had this problem of bleeding gums and sensitive teeth. My jaws were always hurting. Dentists used to say that misaligned teeth actually catch a lot of food in them, and which is not even accessible by brushing teeth. You brush 100 times a day but the food won't go out. So it's like you either get your thoroughly cleaned regularly or just get them straight so that that problem is not there. And if your teeth are like very much misaligned, it can create a lot of problems later in your future. So I got a chance to tell my parents that this is not the only problem. I will lose all my teeth at very young age if I don't get them straightened now. By the way, both of my parents have straight teeth, and I don't know why me and my brother had this fate for ourselves, but anyway. So my parents didn't agree once again, but by that time I was an adult and I was working and earning a little money, so I decided to go through with the treatment all by myself. So back in 2017, when I used to work from home, I was just chilling and working. And I had this thought in mind that if I'm thinking about getting braces, I should just get them. So I spent the whole day researching on the do's and don'ts, if it's okay to get braces as an adult. And finally, I decided that I should consult my dentist. So I went to the dentist and I told her that I want to get braces, and she suggested me that I should get an x-ray first so that the orthodontist can see what needs to be done to my teeth and what is the problem with them. The orthodontist is the one who gets your braces and takes care of all of your treatment, and dentist is takes care of other stuff. I'm not really sure. So I got this x-ray of my whole skull and jaw, and when the orthodontist saw it, he was like, listen, we need to extract 4 of your teeth so that you can get space for your other teeth to align. And that makes me talk about teeth extraction, which is the most common question you guys have asked me. And I know it's very scary to remove teeth from your mouth as an adult, and that too, not one or two but 4 teeth. To be honest, I was scared at first. I was like, okay, you know what, let's not do it, it's a bad idea. But if you even Google, or your dentist will tell you, that teeth extraction is very important part of getting braces. Like if you have misaligned teeth here and there, then you definitely need some space in your mouth for your teeth to get aligned properly. So that's why, to make that space, they have to remove insignificant teeth from 4 corners of your mouth. Those were like one of the most dreadful 2 weeks of my life. They took a whole 2 weeks to extract like 4 teeth because they didn't want me to go through a lot of pain, which is very ironic because I anyway went through like a hell lot of pain. Extracting teeth as an adult is more painful because those are your permanent teeth. So they first inject anesthesia in your jaw before removing the tooth. It's actually generally not that painful at the time, but like there is a lot of blood, but you kind of don't feel any pain. It's kind of numbness over there. But as the anesthesia effect wears down, that's when you actually feel the be prepared that you are definitely gonna get some of your teeth removed. But I want to tell you that it's definitely painful, but it's not that painful that you cannot even, you know, bear it. I tolerated it. The pain was immense, but I still went through it and it was fine in a few weeks. I think human body can handle that amount of pain, so that is fine, totally. So since I was kind of broke at that time and I was like doing it all from my own money and I didn't want to spend so much, so I went with the cheapest option, that is the metallic braces. Otherwise you have more options like ceramic braces and Invisalign. Back then I was just a normal girl who used to work from home, and the only people who ever saw my face were either my housekeepers or 4 or 5 of my friends, sometimes colleagues on work calls. That's all the people I had to face. So I was kind of okay with having metallic braces. I was like, you know, who's gonna see me? Like, I will get this treatment quietly and everything. So the orthodontist told me that the whole treatment will take around 18,000 to 25,000 rupees depending on the amount of time he has to spend. He told me that it will take around 12 to 18 months, but I should not be dependent on it and I should not miss my appointments, and I think that'll be it. So I was like, yeah, okay, then maybe just 1 year, 1.5 year, that's it. And I said, okay, let's get braces. So the installation itself, like, they stick a glue and then they install brackets on each of your teeth. They put a UV light to kind of dry this thing, and then they put a metallic wire through the brackets very tightly so that your teeth start shifting. I still don't understand how braces work. It's kind of like magic. So that installation costed me like 5,000 rupees, and I had to pay 1,500 rupees during every appointment. So every month I used to pay 1,500 rupees till I was done with my whole 25,000. Honest, when he first installed the braces, it felt like so weird, obviously, because you are not used to something and there is suddenly like so much metal in your mouth and you can't even close your mouth properly because there's something there, you know. It definitely takes like a week or two to adjust with them completely, like to completely ignore them from your mouth. But the fact that you're probably gonna be stuck with them for another year or more than that, that just makes you like, chhod yaar, hai to hai, ab hai to hai na. Also, initially my mouth used to get like a lot of ulcers, and occasionally my lips would get stuck somewhere from the bracket and would get cut. My hair would flow and get stuck in the brackets. Food gets stuck in your braces. You can't bite your nails for a long time. But as you grow used to the pain that the braces have, you don't even notice it anymore. Like, the pain is there, but you're so used to it. Having braces is actually a whole lifestyle. There are so many do's and don'ts that you have to do at least for the first year of your braces, because that is when the actual moving of the teeth happens. So the major do's and don'ts for having braces is that you do not eat sticky food, hard food, things you have to bite into, nails. So anything that needs to be like bitten hard, like a walnut, probably an almond, hard chocolates, candies, sticky foods like chewing gum and whole pizza slices, that would actually break your brackets. And if your brackets break, your procedure just goes back. So it's like you are repeating the previous 2 months once again if one of your brackets breaks. So that is serious. That is seriously a bummer. It's like months are getting added to your whole procedure, and trust me, you do not want that. Especially popcorn. Please do not eat popcorn. If a kernel gets stuck in your teeth anywhere, it's gonna pain like hell. It'll be serious hell for you if you have a popcorn kernel stuck in your teeth, because it's not easy to remove and it sticks there for days and it pains like. To be honest with you, I lost a lot of weight during my first initial phase of braces because I simply could not eat anything. So I think win-win for people who are trying to get into diet and cannot, just get braces and it's like two birds, one stone. Now here here comes the actual struggle of my life that I had to face with braces, and it is not really relatable to many of you, not all of you, but maybe some of you. And that is that when you have braces, your face changes a lot, your teeth change a lot, your lips and jaw keep changing at least for one and a half year of your procedure. So be prepared for that. I was not prepared for that. There are gonna be like random gaps in your teeth, maybe front teeth or side teeth, you know, random gaps here and there. It's all actually a part of the process of the teeth getting into their respective positions, so don't worry about that. Also, when your upper teeth are changing, your lips are probably gonna swell up. It mostly happens that your lips are always a bit ahead of your original, like this. They're gonna be like this, but for some reason they also get plumped a lot. The size is increased. So if people ask you if you got surgery, just, I don't know, slap them or something. So my tragic is a very strong word. So my sad story is that I got these braces back in 2017 February when I was just a normal little girl. But something happened in March, April, May, June and July. So I suddenly got like famous on Musical.ly for like some good reason, I don't know. And then I became popular on Instagram too. Like my videos started going viral and everything, and I started getting followers and everything, and people used to see me more than I expected. Like, and it was the worst year for my teeth, and it was the best year for my social media personality, because that is the year when I actually was at the peak of my whatever career stuff. I gained like a lot of followers when I used to look like that, and there would be like sudden random gaps in my teeth and my lips would just swell up one day, and it was kind of weird. I won't say I was ugly, because that is not a good thing to say about yourself, but I definitely look weird, and of course people notice it. And I used to get a lot of comments making fun of my teeth, the gaps, haha, look at you, blah blah blah. Especially the lips, I don't know what the problem was there, because I remember a few comments of girls saying like,
I just find her so irritating, her lips are so annoying.
Like, what problem do you have with my lips? I was reading those comments and now I laugh at them, but at that time I used to get so depressed, like, because it was also new for me, so unexpected, that you never think that people actually would hate you who don't even know you. Whatever confidence I had in my life, it brought it from here to literally here. I just wanted to say that it's not permanent at all, and you do not have to feel bad about yourself. Just think that it is gonna be okay one day, and it's definitely gonna be, because it's just kind of like a process that's going on. There is definitely an end result to it, and it's not forever. My ortho promised me 18 months max, and it went on for 3.5 years. Yes, I got my braces in February 2017, and I got them removed in June 2020. So that is like all of my youth wasted. I actually missed a few appointments. Not a few, I missed a lot of appointments. Those were the days when I used to like be out of station all the time. I used to go on trips and everything, and MNGs and stuff and all of that, and I could not attend my fixed appointments. I don't know why, but orthos can only give you like one appointment in a month, and if you miss it, you miss it. You just have to wait for next month. I don't know what their deal is, but yeah, so you should not miss your appointments. Second is that during the ending phase, my ortho also started bunking a lot. Like, he used to, if you're watching this, Dr. I really am very, very, very thankful to you. I'm just telling them like what happened. I used to keep breaking my brackets by eating food I should not, like candies and stuff. My brackets used to break and my procedure used to just rewind. But the major factor was there was this one gap in the upper left side. Like, you can say for 6 months, my teeth were just like this, like they are right now. But this one gap wouldn't just dust fill. It's still there. It's not visible. Actually, my ortho was just trying to see what happens with this. But in the end, we finally gave up. Like, it's not even moving. So just let's end it here. It's not even a significant gap. You can't even really see it. We decided to just end the treatment in June 2020. And here I am, smiling. So let me rewind a bit. 2017, I got braces. It was fine till 6 months. Then after 6 months, my teeth started having different gaps and my lips started becoming weird. That happened for another 8 to 10 months till all of them finally aligned themselves, leaving the 4 gaps as it is. And that was in November 2018. Yes. Then the process was to kind of push your molars to the front and also all of these teeth a little bit closer to each other and the whole jaw a bit inside of your mouth. I don't know if it makes sense, like just push everything a bit inside. So that whole thing took them around another 8 months, I should say. And then we were just waiting for this gap. So that went on for another whatever, do the math. You need to keep your mouth seriously very clean all the time. You need to brush your teeth twice a day. Always brush it before going to sleep because food can get stuck in your teeth and your braces. It can cause like a lot of problems. Some food can, if it gets stuck in your mouth, it can really cause a lot of pain also. It's just, normal hygiene that you really have to brush your teeth a lot, okay? Just brush your teeth, okay? So now that my braces are removed, it's not the end of everything, okay? There is something called as retainers. You have to wear your retainers for another 6 months, 1 year, depending on your treatment and procedure. You can remove them whenever you want, but it's advised that you wear them sincerely all the time. Only remove them when you are brushing your teeth and when you are eating. So my dentist gave me these transparent retainers. There are other metallic retainers also, but I think these transparent retainers are more common, and these are made of plastic and they go on each of your jaw. The reason why I'm not wearing them right now is because they kind of cause a little bit of lisp. Like I find it difficult to speak very fast, and actually they cause a lot of saliva in my mouth. So I don't want to spit on the camera, so that's why I'm not wearing these right now. But I wear them all the time except for when I am eating and recording. Also, you need to clean these every day when you are brushing your teeth. I clean them like during night when I brush my teeth. I will just quickly show you how I wear these. It's gonna be kind of graphic, so just be prepared for that. Do I sound different? I definitely speak different, but whatever, it feels different. You can't even notice that they are even there. And in first 2 or 3 days, it gives a problem. But after 2 or 3 days, you're like used to it. You don't even notice if they are still there. I have to wear mine continuously for 6 months because my treatment was already like very long. And my teeth have been in this shape for more than 6 months. So my retainers are not gonna last that long. But usually people wear retainers for 1 or 2 years probably. If you do not wear your retainers, your teeth are gonna get back into their original shape. That is the bad news I wanted to tell you. I've heard like a lot of stories that people got irritated with their retainers. Sorry, spit. So people got irritated with their retainers and they stopped wearing them, and then their teeth went back to their original shapes and they either left the treatment and just let it go, or they had to do the whole braces treatment once again, which I'm sure nobody wants to do. So please do not forget to wear your retainers. Always wear them. So getting braces overall has increased my self-confidence a lot. For me, it was a tough 3.5 years, but it was still worth it. Also, I wanted to tell you that my bleeding gums problem has also vanished and my teeth are not sensitive anymore. They are pretty healthy. So I really, really hope this video helped you. And if you were planning to get on braces, or you have just gotten braces, or you simply just like me have experienced all of this. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Also, since I have made my honorable comeback on this app once again, so I would definitely want your suggestions to tell me what kind of videos you want to see, because I'd probably be active once again unless my laptop dies again. So I don't know. If you have come this far, just do not forget to follow me on Instagram, Snapchat, and also on Twitter, and especially on Snapchat, because there are like a lot of secrets that Instagram people don't know that I post only exclusively on Snapchat. To know me head top to bottom, just follow me everywhere. Do not forget to subscribe to this channel. My battery is running out, so I'm just gonna say that goodbye, guys. Thank you for watching it up till here. I love you all so much, and subscribe to my channel. Subscribe just like right now. It was fun coming back. I miss you all. Thank you so much. I love you. Bye.